I'm Mashu Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here to do a little Modern Masters drafting, or Vintage Masters drafting, excuse me. I don't have a ton of experience with the format because it's just come out, but I've done like 3 or 4 drafts. So this pack, we have an unexciting rare, unfortunately, no power. I think this card's probably fine. I mean, it is a 6-mana 7-7, but I want to take Lightning Rift. I really like the cycling deck, as I'm sure basically every article I've ever seen written has said, and Lightning Rift is a great first pick to give you, you know, just a ton of direction in your draft. So we're just going to slam that. Alright, so this pack, we've got a Cycling Land, which are always good. Goblin Trenches, which I've been pretty impressed with. I think the card's pretty underrated. A Fetch Land, which is whatever. Not that exciting. A nice cycling card. A couple nice cycling cards, actually. I tend to think that blue is the best color. And then I'm fine splashing whatever, especially when you get just like a critical density of cyclers. It doesn't matter that much what color your cards are. So I think I want to just go ahead and nab this cycler. I like blue-red a lot, like I said. And we'll see if any of these three wheel. These are the other three cards I would consider taking here. So I'll just take that. Alright, it's a nice foil Sphere of Resistance. I don't think the card's very good in draft, but... So the best cards here are Wild Mongrel, which I think is the best green common. Lonely Sandbar is obviously quite good. Fits well with what we're trying to do so far. Yeah, so for me it's between the Wild Mongrel and the Sandbar. And I think I'll just take the Wild Mongrel. If we end up getting like totally cut out of red or whatever, you know, and don't want to play this Lightninger for some reason, this card's just really good. Blue-Green Madness is a really good deck. So, yeah, I'll just snap it up. Okay, well, here's a Prophetic Bolt, so that pushes us solidly black back into blue-red, which is fine. We only missed out on a Lonely Sandbar, which is a great card, but... This card's just absurd. 4 damage to, you know, it usually is kill a creature, draw a card at 5 mana, which is insane. And the card selection from it is great. The other cards are Deep Analysis and Rescind are the two cards I would want. And I suppose Noble Templar is fine as well. But we're just going to take the Bolt. Alright, so we've got another Choking Tethers, which is acceptable. Mana Prism, which is also pretty good. And Chartreuse Cougar, which I think is the pick. It's a good creature. It's nice to have like a solid creature as well. Helps out with mana fixing and cycles, so really does it all. Yeah, it's pretty simple. So Turnabout is a card, sort of. Turnabout and Aftershock are both good. I really like Suchi a lot, though. It's just an efficiently costed creature. I mean, most decks would jump at the chance to play... I can't remember what the 4-mana 4-4 from M14 was, but getting to play that in colorless with an upside... I mean, this card obviously used to have a drawback, but now, you know, when it dies, you might get to cycle for free or something. So it's pretty good. If this weren't in the pack, I'd probably want to take this Radiance Judgment. I think it goes excellently in Lightning Rift decks, because if they have a little guy, you kill it with the Lightning Rift. If they have a big guy, you kill it with the Judgment. So it's pretty good. But we'll just take Suchi and be happy. All right, we have Scrivener, which is quite good. What does this thing do? Okay, that seems pretty bad. Yeah, I think we're probably just going to take Scrivener. We have Prophetic Bolt, Choking Tethers. We can pick up more... cycling spells to get back, which is always great. And you just usually end up with a lot of spells in your blue-red deck anyway. Scab land would also be fine, but these lands are not that good. They're okay. But land cyclers are a much better form of fixing, I think. So we'll just scriven away. Okay, we got Circular Logic and Temporal Fissure and Owl Familiar. I don't really want any of these stupid goblin guys. I think I want Circular Logic. Counter spells in general are just pretty strong. And if we end up with a couple of frantic searches or whatever, then this card gets even better. The cycling decks tend to have pretty full graveyards, so it's usually as close to a hard counter as you could want. So here our World Gorger Dragon lapped. I might just take that as our finisher of sorts. The other option being Secluded Step or this fetch land in case we get some Brainstorms. Or like open a Trop or something in the next pack. But I think we just wanna eat the world. This card seems like it would be good. I mean, I guess it's pretty bad if they kill it with the trigger on the stack, but you can play around that. Here we will take the fetch. I suppose we could take the Dark Ritual just because Storm is probably going to be not a great matchup. But I think having a fetch in case we end up with Brainstorms in our deck is probably higher upside. Here I am going to take Cabal Ritual just because I don't care about any of these other cards. And I'm scared of Storm. I don't know. I guess we'll take Sarcomancy. Alright, this card I could imagine playing under some circumstances. And I could totally imagine playing Aftershock. I don't think it's very good, but I could imagine playing it. So, right now we have, the starts of a pretty nice blue-red control deck. Alright, again, no power, unfortunately. This pack is a little weaker than our first pack was. We don't have an obvious first pick. Talarian Academy is sweet, but not something that is particularly strong in draft. Or valuable enough that we would want to select it. So I think for me it's between Waterfront Bouncer and Rescind. The Bouncer's obviously cool with cards like Circular Logic, and we could pick up the one mana one that draws a card and stuff like that. Rescind is also obviously very nice, and it cycles. I think we'll take the Bouncer, though, just to give us a way to create a board presence on turn two. Ought to be pretty strong. Alright. This card's really, really good. Like, almost unbeatable for a deck like ours. Like, we're never going to beat it, but also we're not necessarily going to be able to play it. We don't have any planes or other white cards yet. I think Serendib is probably pretty strong also. And then Circular Logic and Chainlightning are both just solid cards. So I think that Serendib is probably better than Circular Logic, and Ophidian also probably is better than Circular Logic. But that being said, I think we're going to want the cheap removal spell in Chainlightning. It's also versatile. You can go to the face if we need to later. And I think it's pretty strong. Alright, there's a Kindle, which I think is what we want to take. We are pretty low on cyclers right now. But we have, right now we just have like sort of decent-ish guys and burn spells, which seems like a pretty good place to be. This card's also fine, just because the creatures in this format in general are not very large. But taking Kindles early and often is nice. This card also seems okay. I don't know. I haven't played with it that much. It's pretty insane in your Battle Screech deck, probably. But we'll just Kindle away. Alright, here is a deep analysis. I would love to take Lonely Sandbar, but I just can't justify it over an excellent draw spell like this. Works well with our Waterfront Bouncer. It's just an excellent spell in general. We'll grab that. Maybe I should be taking some of these cyclers a little higher, but whatever. So we have Rescind versus Kenai Aven. I don't really think we want Caldera Lake that badly. And I think we have enough nice creatures in Suchi and World Gorger Dragon and Chartreuse Cougar that we can pass on a Killer Whale. So I think it's between the two cyclers. I tend to prefer Kenai Aven to Rescind just because it is also a solid board presence. Against decks like the Battle Screech deck, it's nice to have a reasonably sized flying creature that just blocks, you know, can help to shut down the Battle Screeching, at least to some extent. So, Brainstorm looks like the pick. None of these other cards are all that good. Simeon Grunts is nice and all, but these green cards are pretty good, but we're not going to splash for it. So some more Circular Logic versus Secluded Step. We'll just take the Circular Logic. Goes very nicely with our Waterfront Bouncer. Doesn't really work with Owl Familiar, unfortunately. I think I want to take Goblin Settler as a sideboard card. I don't think Owl Familiar is very good, especially because to Madness with it, unless it's in like a blue-green Madness deck with Root Wallace, you have to have mana up, so it costs 3 instead of 2, which is not quite as good a deal. However, Goblin Settler could be a good sideboard card against like the Kel'Jorn Outpost that we passed. So it's nice to have that available to us, even if we're definitely not going to start it. Alright, so Rescind came back for us, which is good because we picked a Kenai Aven over it before, so being able to have one of each is excellent. Alright, well, I don't think we want a third Circular Logic. I think we'd rather have our first Ophidian. Ophidian is a nice one, so pretty easy pick. Surprised that it wheeled, too. Repel is fine, it's just Griptide, basically. I don't think this is a Goblin Patrol deck, and none of these green cards are interesting to us. I guess we'll hate the Predatory Nightstalker. We're not going to start Goblin General, and these green spells are not interesting. Oh, okay. I don't mind Killer Whale. It's a perfectly serviceable guy. Skirk Drill Sergeant is also fine, but not amazing. I guess we'll take the Hulking Goblin.